That's us. That's Chris's Strahd session 21 coming up. Hey, what's up, everybody? It is November 26th, and we're getting ready to have Thanksgiving. But before we have that, we're going to have a session of Dungeons and Dragons 5th edition. We are in Curse's Strahd. The characters are level 5. Level 5. Actually, they're this close to level 6. I mean, even if I gave you your experience points right now that's in there, you still wouldn't level up. Because it's like 190 divided by 5. I don't think that's even enough to do it.
Well, Grim's got a plan to make that experience real quick.
Right? There's like, you're like, look up ahead. Did you guys get
scarecrows? This?
Did you guys get this image? This one right here? Ha ha. Yeah. Give that a second to load.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, Grim's gonna run out there and kite these scarecrows around in a circle and get tighter and tighter and tighter till they're in a big group, and then just have Javelda just boom, one fireball, done.
There's not a whole lot of running around in that swamp. I just saying it's kind of difficult terrain, yeah. And they're kind of spread out. But hold on, before you guys do all that, let's get some descriptions and stuff going on. Someone, you don't know who, built a ramshackle wooden hut on the stump of what was once an enormous tree. The rotting roots of the stump thrust up from the mire like legs of a gigantic spider. An open doorway is visible on one side of the hut, beneath which floats the upside down, hollowed out skull of a giant. Flanking the hut's doorway are two iron cages that dangle like hideous ornaments from the eaves. Scores of ravens are trapped in each one. They squawk and flutter their wings excitedly.
Shit, they're giving us away. Damn, where ravens told on us.
Now, you guys are seeing this around, right? I'm giving you guys some time to kind of scan the area before you
scope it.
Like, alarm everything.
Leroy!
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Yeah, if we could roll initiative. I got the button right here. So what are you guys thinking? You see that green light?
Mm-hmm.
That's the hut. And then up back here, on the top, that's the old manor. And then down here, these are the little shacks. Everything's covered in muck. Mud and
it's a bog, man.
And that was bogs. that was the flickering light over there. It was the, you already talked to her, the druid lady, the keeper of the flock of feathers. What do they call it? The keepers of the feather, the were-raven.
Yeah. She's a druid? The were-raven?
She didn't have a class tag on.
Yeah, she didn't have her druid.
She's standing in a druid circle looking very druidic.
Letterman sweater. Yeah. Okay.
You didn't see any metal objects on her? She had mistletoe in her hair. I mean...
Oh, dude, this thing's head's twitching. That's cool.
So you've seen the scarecrows, obviously, and these things look like they're just positioned out there as like maybe a alert system, like guards. But they're just hanging there on their sticks as you guys are like peeking over this hill, right? You're kind of checking them out. I changed the scale because the 100 feet per square was a little ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's a bit much, yeah.
I mean, I kind of did it to maybe what is kind of sort of close to the scale. It should be, right? Kind of.
Yeah, we just
these
need
buildings
a,
and
something.
Stuff.
And,
you know?
It's
yeah.
a battle map.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it looks good.
It'll work.
I was going to put some water in the river and all that, but, you know, I didn't.
Slacker.
Hey, I got this image. This is a cool image. If you haven't seen it, I'm stalling a little, seeing where Sphinster's at. Did...
Well, I
pinged
Graham,
him too.
Graham
see,
tells Relkina she ought to run out there and attack that scarecrow. And Relkina goes, oh, okay.
Wait,
just
how does she say
kidding.
Okay.
She has a Spanish accent?
Attack that. Yes, she purrs when she talks. You've never noticed a rare Kina purrs when she talks?
Yeah, she rolls her R's and her N's.
She's coughing up a hairball.
How does she roll her N's?
Rep Kina,
you have a new one.
No. Like the Bionic Woman. No. That's how you're rolling in.
Or Batman. No.
So,
baby racing.
You guys want to get as close to one of these scarecrows as you can, and then just run over there and start beating on it. 20 minutes. I mean, you don't have like a stealthy total party.
No,
I'm clanging.
I mean, Relkenya.
Yeah.
Is your stealth, I think.
That's about it.
Still invisible. Lasts an hour or so.
When did you guys cast that? Up on the hill?
Just before she went up on the hill.
Like, oh, up here? Like when you guys got here? Yeah, you guys haven't been here in an hour. I was thinking that you used it the last battle with the, up on the...
No. It was when we got here and we were about to cross the river and go check out that
oh,
little
yeah,
stuff on the hill.
Oh, yeah, bopping around on the monoliths or the standing stones over here. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
so
she's
Kenya,
still invisible.
She can stealth up there and find out what's up with that scarecrow, right?
She wants to go check out which scarecrow. This one?
Yeah, I'd say the nearest one there.
Right up the road.
Well, guess what? Guess what? The DM has a button he's got to push and he can't find it now. This one? No. Huh. Was I supposed to make this encounter and I didn't?
We already killed all these scarecrows over at the other place. Or those other scarecrows.
These are more.
More scarecrows. It sounds unrealistic.
Alright, hold on. I gotta back up.
20 minutes.
Back up. Well, here we go. Approaching. Oh, yeah. There's also, like, lots of flies, biting flies, like, everywhere. And if you guys, like, linger too long, like, okay, hold on 1 second. I don't know what she was going on about, my Alexa. But if you guys like try to get a short rest, you get bit by flies, so you can't linger in spots too long. But the scarecrows should be like that. Yeah. All right. Hold on. I still need to drag this into the party sheet. XP. Like that. Because we're having one of these. Well, one of these. Yeah. I was delayed.
I'm always at the bottom.
All right, so who's going up there? Rokenya? Makes sense, doesn't it? Like,
yeah.
22 initiative.
Yep.
All right, so Rokenya, she like, I'm invisible. I'm going to go and check it out. So she gets like, when she gets in like 20 feet from the scarecrow, she sees that it's just a rag doll scarecrow hanging there stuffed with wheat. She doesn't think it's going to do anything. And then like the ground kind of like pulses with like this necrotic, like, and you see like a spirit kind of shoot up into the scarecrow, like an evil one, and it turns and it lets out a silent cackle. And then you see like bloop, bloop, all over the swamp, these scarecrows come alive. But they're not very noisy, but they seem to
not
hear each other.
It, man.
Blop, blop. And they're like, do they hop around on the pole? Is that doink, 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 doink?
Pogo stick.
All right, so what do you guys think Rokenya would do? Fight or flight?
Hiss.
Meow.
Does it see her? She's invisible. Does it know? I mean, is it?
It obviously sensed her presence. It might not actually see her per se, as in like, can I see you? But you don't necessarily have to be seen to have your presence known. I still might have disadvantage on hitting you, but and Rokenya could have. She's a bow.
Because she's invisible, she can just step back, even if she's adjacent to him, right? So
she didn't actually get quite adjacent when started moving. So that's why I'm asking you guys. Do you think she would fight?
I think
flight?
She would freeze. I don't think she'd stand there and fight. No.
She got her bow out, I would imagine.
I think she'd move away from it and keep just kind of scoping things out if she can. But if it looks like, I mean, if it looks like, you know, that the alarm's been tripped or whatever, she'd probably scurry back to the.
Definitely the alarms were triggered. You guys.
Yeah, that's kind of what I'm thinking. Yeah. Like, yeah. If we're seeing the ground farting up bubbles of spirits
shooting up into the scarecrows.
It's like walking through places in Louisiana. I've stepped here and 4 feet over here, the ground's went, you know.
All right, I'm gonna say that she's gonna finish her movement, her turn. What can I move token? What'd I do? I'm on the play button. What can I move Rokenya's token? What kind of flying. I don't know. All right, so I'm going to just move her back over here behind this hill as her action to move for now. And she will get out her bow. She's like, meow, these are alarms. Rost.
All right. Rost is going to emboldening bond our tanks and Kenya too, even though she's not actually here. yeah, that worked. That's my action.
Right. This one's all like somebody put too much straw in his shirt, and he's gonna start heading this way towards the commotion on the hill. What is that over there? Oh, this button. I'm stalling because, oh, they got a standard 30 feet of movement. Yeah, but I don't see how they can move any faster in this muck than you guys, so I'm going to move them up, like, over here. Like, he's like, he's still on his pole, right? He's just hopping through the muck. I don't know how he's doing it, but... but they're not moving very fast. Oh, that's why somebody took the stuffing out of the first one. Out of this guy and gave it to the first one. That's unusually emaciated. He's gonna remain over there. He's on extra duty over there. Very corpse-like. Well, this one's definitely sensed some stuff coming this way. And I can see you guys up on the hill. You're not hiding from me. Maybe if I lock the tokens, it might help us. What are you bombing?
Nothing yet.
Nothing yet? All right, so this one's going to come trudging all the way up to the top of the hill. You see it's like its eyes are looking at you. They're looking terrifying, but it was a lot of muck, and I think he had to dash to get there, so... He can't use his glare. Remember you guys were closing your eyes fighting these things last time? Giving yourself disadvantage on purpose? It was nice. I liked it. Trudging this way. Notice I'm counting the exact amount of movement. Grimfoot. I just dragged him.
Okay.
You had a pretty good view up on the hill there.
Yeah, and I don't plan on getting down in that muck either. I don't like it.
Well, you've been Grimfoot, kind of in it already, but not
right.
At the
right, yeah. But I mean, I'm not gonna. I don't want to go fight out there. They can come to us. I will, of course, bonus action rage because, you know, anything that looks like that just pisses me off. And I think I'm going to move. Kind of right around here.
Slip sliding around the backside?
Yeah, sliding around the backside. I like doing that. I'm going to not attack this thing because I didn't have it targeted.
17 hits.
Okay. Too many windows open. Window creep going on here. 17 hits. I will target them this time.
Did you want to rage?
That's thrown, but it doesn't matter. I did rage.
He's raging.
Oh. I see it.
Yeah.
I can read. I just wasn't looking.
And then again, it did the same damage, so I didn't roll again. And then we'll leave him there for Sir Chan Destroy to kill steal from me, and I will down air.
These things have a few hit points, huh?
More than one.
Hefty, hefty, hefty. He comes trudging up. Is that what a scarecrow in the muck sounds like? I don't know. You're getting your wish. This one comes all the way up. Like, gets some ground and comes trudging across the top. With its icky... its claws hanging out. Right? I don't know if any of you guys are in 2D mode. but that's all I can do. He could double and look cool. Menacing. All right, Javelda. Your fireball grouping
going
is
back up the road a little bit.
Limited.
Yeah.
Yeah. These things are creepy. Yeah. On top of that hill, I'll let you move full movement. Almost everywhere else is pretty difficult.
You guys got that one under control. So I'm going to firebolt this one.
You have this knowledge that they don't like fire.
I kind of seem to have a vague memory of that fact.
Neither did the twig blights. Holy smokes, what happens when you catch straw on fire?
Hopefully it stays on fire.
Yeah, little, right.
A little light source appears next to you. You're like, hey, I can see a little better now.
Right next to Rost.
Sir Chandistra is going to take a swing at this very corpse-like scarecrow and try to turn him into a corpse.
He was a corpse earlier. The spirit.
They stuff the corpse inside the scarecrow? Is that what they're using for scarecrows now?
And swing at him a second time. With a backhand.
What is... They don't have any armor. They're like, just hit me. Alright! So you kill it and you see this spirit just kind of like hits the muck and kind of dissipates like oil on water. Kind of spreads out and sinks into the mirror. The mirror? The mire? The mirror.
Mire. Mire.
Where are you from? Crick? Creek?
Mire.
Pecan.
He's going to keep his shield up so he don't get stared at.
The one behind you?
Yeah. Close my eyes. Wait for him to come to me.
Closing an eyes, an action, is that... What is 5e? Underfed. Underfed. Oh, okay. That's better. Underfed.
He's underfed.
Where the hell is this guy? Oh, this guy. Yeah. He's going to be like...
That like excessively nerfed, he's underfed.
Unnerved or unnerfed?
Durf. Combat tracker, he's unnerfed. Undurfed.
He's unnerfed. Underfed.
Undurfed.
Undurfed.
Underfed.
Underfed, undurfed.
Undurfed Ed. Well, we know his name's Ed.
He used to be Ed. Now he's Mr. Scarecrow. Unusually emaciated is also now starting to move this way. As I need to no, yes. As I'll take these out of there. As we have some more added to the encounter, as you guys see this entire like hut that you guys had the green light, like stand up into the swamp and start lifting its tree trunks like it's starting to move. But you also see a humanoid, a person, a lady, an old lady climbing into the upside down floating skull way over there at the edge of your
So she could hear us over the sound of those ravens. Great.
Well, no. One of the scarecrows went inside and made some shaky... what was his name?
Did a shaky interpretive dance?
Underfed. Yeah. Got her attention. They are their her guards, so... Bloated. Did Bloated do his thing? Which one's bloated? This one?
I've been feeling a little bloated lately.
What? I'll be feeling more bloated once Thanksgiving's done.
Yeah.
Friday night in Sven's game.
I think he's going to be moving up.
Be barely conscious then.
Hefty.
Tryptophan.
Uh-oh.
Tryptophan.
It's not enough tryptophan to even freaking make you yawn.
No.
It's the big being a
It's overeating carbs.
Eating, yeah.
That does it.
Yeah, all the stuffing and then the rolls and then the sweet potatoes and then the...
All right, so this one doesn't know that he can't terrify and gaze you, which is a action. So it comes up and goes right in Grimfoot's face, and Grimfoot's like, I'm raging, I don't care. So we don't have to roll.
I don't care.
I don't know if you say it like that or not, but all right. Search and destroy.
Well, he's gonna turn around and go hit this one.
Are you keeping your eyes closed?
Yes.
Giving yourself disadvantage?
Yes. No. He's got blindsight.
Nice. Ross is like, no, not me!
I don't know. You're kind of skinny. It might be hard to tell the difference.
No, the ugly one.
Wait.
Aren't you a paladin?
Yeah.
You save all your
he forgot how to smite.
For spells? What kind of paladin are you?
The one that's getting ready to face this great big walking fucking tree stump.
Yeah. The whole point of me throwing encounters at you is to burn down some spell slots. That's the whole point. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. All right, Grimfoot.
Hmm.
Okay, I'm going to turn around and deal with this one. Yeah, we'll select that one right there because it needs selecting. And I think I'm going to go ahead and...
You're going to move up on
recklessly
him?
Attack. Am I not? Yeah. I'm in. There we go.
That I kind of left it up to you if you wanted to be or not. Because he didn't quite get to you quite.
I'm not used to this. This is the first time I've used the 2D map during combat. So here, I'll get squared up with him.
Yeah, I'm...
I can't really tell.
I'm not... I'm not good at it as a DM yet.
It's a lot harder to tell, like, movement and distances that way.
Did I not put... I should have rolled advantage, because I hit reckless attack. That doesn't matter. I hit him.
Well, roll one more time and see if you critted.
That's all right. Let's try it again. Does it say reckless attack on me there? Nope. Okay, maybe I just didn't get it clicked. We'll try it again.
There it is.
And...
It makes a little thing right in chat. See?
Nah, there we go.
See, look at that.
Almost.
You still hit. It's amazing. No one's missed yet.
Yeah, and... I'm going to move. I'm going to stay on the road. And he'll have an op shot against me.
Why wouldn't he take it? I don't know.
Yeah, no reason not to take it. I have to turn off his 2D. I can't really deal with it for...
I turned it off, too. Yeah, claw. Disadvantage? Oh, advantage, because you're
No,
reckless.
Advantage. Yeah.
But yeah, it still scratches your shield.
Yeah, and I'm going to move right back there.
Oh, hold on. I got to get rid of that guy. Doop. Oh, no, don't do that. Oh.
Actually, I want to...
I thought I hit the just a little bit more. NPC button. Remove all NPC buttons. I thought I did a Doug Davison.
That didn't work anyway. Okay, yeah, that's good. Down arrow.
Oh. Oh, yeah. So you guys hear, like, off over by that cabin that's just started to sprout legs and come this way. It's making some noise as it's digging its tree trunks out of the muck and turning. But in the background, you guys hear... What? What? As the giant skull kind of takes flight. Like,
is that Marvin the Martian or Jetsons?
That's the Jetsons.
You're making me very angry.
All right. So there's that giant skull. And there's somebody in it. I'm not turning on the person in it. All you see is like... like this cow, like
a
yawny
cow?
Looking freaking hood pulled over, and then eyes sticking out of the skull is all you see, like 3/4 cover. It hasn't like started your way yet. It's just like loading up in it.
That's what I heard, Marbania.
Bessie, yeah, it sounded like the cow.
What happened? Oh, wait, I gotta put this in the...
So you see this cow.
Poor sheep.
Like, oh, wait, no.
Cow.
Cowl.
There's a what's an cow. L?
Moo. Think of that cartoon character that, yeah.
Okay, I got window creep. All right, Rel Kenya, you have your bow out, and you started the whole mess. Just saying. Just saying. Hey. You crept up and you weren't so crept up.
All right.
It's amazing that she's just now getting.
So the skull is only a medium. It's only medium.
The skull
it's not a large. So the thing in it is small?
It says medium vehicle, but I don't think so.
Okay. They haven't been hurt, so I'm not worried about them.
Well, a horse is a medium, isn't it? No, a horse is a large creature. Why would this...
horses are large.
It's Yoda inside.
Alright, and is this...
I see you, yes.
So is the scaling accurate? In other words, it says I am 125 feet, is that correct?
You can only see 120 feet, though. It's murky.
So it's correct.
This is pretty close, yeah. For bow cool. shot and I am, stuff like that, yeah.
So I won't worry about the skull just yet. I'm going to run up. I don't get
now,
very often.
The only place that's not difficult terrain is the ridge of the hill, like where everybody's kind of at. Everything else is monkey swamp and is difficult.
Yeah, show him that picture.
Gotcha.
Oh, did he not get it? Let's share it.
No. Varez. It's black.
Give it a second.
Just give it a second to load.
Okay. A little nodding skeleton. Scarecrow.
See the skull
thing in front of the hut. Yep.
Very cool. Very nice.
What's the city on the hill behind it?
That's the manor. It's not really a city. Those are trees mostly. But there's a couple of tall fronts to the manor.
This is from your Patreon friend?
Yeah. The one I never can see. James RPG art. James
That's
RPG.
It.
Nice. Very cool. Jimmy. All right, so I'm running up and I'm going to...
Yeah, he loves Curse of Strahd too. There's a lot. But he's got other stuff. All right, let's... You guys don't need that.
So, real quick, before I have a thing that says any weapon attack I make. So I have presumed that does not count my unarmed strike, which is my claws. So I just wanted to clarify with you, do my claws count as weapons?
You would have
officially
natural
an unarmed strike.
I believe if we counted your unarmed strike as weapons, we'd be nerfing the monk. Right.
Do you have an ability called natural weapon? No, I'm thinking of Savage Worlds. Never mind.
Monks get their unarmed strikes become weapons. So, but you have like a thing that says you have claws and you can do damage with them. Like part
correct.
Of your...
And I don't racial trait. What I'm
yeah,
talking
so
about.
So those are weapons.
Is...
Yeah. Those are weapons. Cat's claws. Oh, it says you
when you hit a creature with a weapon, you can deal an extra 1d4 psychic damage to the target. That's what I'm talking about. Dreadful strikes. So I've presumed it did not count my claws. So I'm asking if I'm correct, or can I count my claws to do my dreadful strike? You understand the question?
I'm looking at your claws. Yeah.
Cat's claws is the trait. And it's doesn't let me share. Doesn't have the little share chat thing anymore. I don't like it.
Certain things had it, but
anyway.
Okay. So you just want to use your claw for instead of a dagger. Right?
So there's a thing I just shared. Dreadful strikes. So read that. For now, I'm just going to attack with my other weapon and let me know if you think my claws would count for towards
this. This is part of your Feywanderer. You can augment your weapon strikes with mind scarring magic drawn from Gloomy Halls of the Feywild. Yeah, I think that would be cool as shit if you did that with your claws. Hell yeah, you can do it with your claws. Like, and you like draw some of their freaking psyche out. Nice. Yeah, it's not over P or nothing. What's nice. The difference?
Okay.
It's flavor.
So I'm going to run up and I'm just going to.
Do you like leap use your back claws?
And rake at him.
Like cats do.
My claws.
Rawr, with your back claws. Rawr.
Show your belly and wait for him to try to rub your belly.
That's right.
Yeah.
Why do I
advantage?
Oh, advantage, okay.
Why do you have? Because
you're still invisible.
Oh, that's true. We forgot to mention that part.
Okay. I hit.
You're no longer invisible.
Nope.
I wonder if I need to take that off.
It says it was deactivated, so.
No, it still says it's on you.
It's gone.
Oh. Speedy Gonzalez. Epa, epa.
I have less things open to get confused by.
It should have been one more damage. Boo. To hit. My third strut, my offhand. My other claw. There you go. So my first one was actually offhand, so this one counts as my main. Either way. So slash, 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 striking into the thing.
I just double check and then make sure he doesn't have one hit point, because I would give it to you if he did. Because I saw where you rolled the wrong die. Also, he didn't close your eye, so we'll have that if he lives for his turn to see if we can scare the kitty cat. Meow. Rost.
All right, somebody redeemed a level up for Rost in
what?
The chat.
Oh, crap, I didn't have Oh, nice. At the next long rest, you can get your level up.
All right.
But you can't combine that with any other offers.
All right, I'm going to, so I don't have to...
Sorry, I didn't even have my chatty open.
So I don't have to look at this guy, too close. I'm just going to toll the dead at him and, like, put my shield up right in between me and him so I don't have to see him.
Like, I know you're over there.
Nice.
Whoa.
Oh, almost dead. And then bonus action, I'm going to summon my spiritual weapon. And,
ooh.
Let's see.
I'll finish him off.
I'm going to try. There we go. There it is. And.
Yield him in the face.
I don't have to do shit as a DM anymore.
Oh, max damage.
Nice.
Seated by one.
Nice. Dead.
Blood spot.
And.
Black Ichor. Fades into the swamp.
Black straw.
And
the straw is just kind of floating there.
Spiritual weapon. Getting ready for next turn.
Wait, what? Why is it just an X there?
Oh, that's weird.
Understand.
Yeah, I saw that the other day in Gorgio's game.
Okay. I'll just move it like over here somewhere like that?
Yeah, over there somewhere. Just trying to move it to be more central.
We need to like, move it over and smash this guy in the face right here?
Sure, that works too. Well, I can't attack him this turn, so. Yeah.
Yeah, because you already. Yeah. Why can't you?
Yeah.
Did you use it?
Yeah, that's how I killed
that
guy. Oh, yep.
That's what Smoosh Team. Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. What's this? This is the long one here, so I just reviewing what's in the skull.
The skull casts meteor swarm. We're all dead.
It's a dairy cow. It's from California, then they're happy. It's a happy cow.
It's the Chick-fil-A cow.
Eat
more chicken.
Yeah. Eat more chicken.
Yeah, I went to the doctor, and this was the last Halloween, and one of the nurses was dressed up as a cow, and she says, a lot of people say, oh, you're a cow. I'm like, well, you need the Ebor chicken sign, and everybody will love it. And she's like, goes running off. You're great. That's perfect. She comes running back later with a sign. It's perfect. All right, so there's stuff happening over there. Javelda.
All right, well, I see this one over by Real Kenya. Am I going to have a minus
He's
on
all
that?
Messed up. Got straw everywhere. This thing is all torn to crap.
Yeah, probably. There's some big boys in your way.
Yeah.
Well, you don't care. Through the legs.
It's all good.
Around the bush. 23
Explode.
Points of damage.
Exceeded by 23.
Yeah. So, what were those big towers of Gondor that they lit? That's, you know. So people can see the signal for miles
around. The beacons.
Around. Yeah.
Right.
Back. We're a little bit more
playing with firecrackers, and we're throwing them in like dump trucks, smoke bombs mostly. We had a big bag of
this just July 4th
black cat firecrackers. No, this was like long after that, and somebody threw a freaking smoke grenade and it hit a branch and landed right in the bag of firecrackers. Holy moly. It's kind of what that happened to that guy right there. Vigorous. He's vigorously
scooted back just a little bit more, but yeah.
Trying to make his way over here. Oh, she's like, remember 120 feet is your vision. Yeah. If you want to get off the north side of the map.
I'm not going that far.
He's going to come over next to his buddy and be like,
I don't
hey,
like these nasty
what's
things.
What's this? Thing what he points to that looks at him. Can Scarecrow shrug and anyone would notice? Do they have shoulders? Guess that's a shrug, right? There's a lot in the combat tracker right now. Starts coming this way. Ooh.
Just what exactly is an underfed scarecrow? What do you feed scarecrows?
He's underfed.
We actually named him Underfed.
Underfed. Okay. Nice.
All right, so this thing doesn't really seem to be slowed down too much by the muck, but it does start coming your way.
Do we see anybody driving it? Is there anything visible on the outside?
You saw somebody come out of it and get into a flying skull, which is now kind of like floating behind it and next to it as it starts heading your way. All of it, including the rest of the scarecrows that are over that way, too.
Nice fireball formation.
You also see like the, like one of the roots of the hut. Like reaches up out of the muck, and it has a rock, a boulder, you know, like medicine ball size ish, maybe a little bigger, like caught up in its root, and it's like as it's moving towards you guys. Unusually emaciated. kind of does some high ground moving over there. Let me do this. Doesn't really have a term, that thing, does it? Javelda. Barely see that spot clear. But yeah. Are you talking now? We don't hear you.
Yes, as sorry. As Rokinya said, perfect fireball formation, and it's right at the edge of that 120, but I can see it. So we're gonna fireball.
Nice.
Three failures.
Well, that takes care of that scarecrow.
Yeah.
It's funny.
Get for tattletailing.
Did you affect the thing inside the skull?
I have no idea. Did what was in the skull get targeted and affected? Because as far as I know, it wasn't.
I'm double checking. Yeah, you don't get no cover from fireball. What you talking about, Beavis? You weren't sure if it did or not, but you know the fireball went off. Don't listen to that.
Didn't hear nothing.
Figures? Oh, he gets to go again? Oh, it's early in the round, isn't it? Well, I don't know. I think I want this guy. Comes running up to Rel Kenya, running. I don't know if I'd say running. And gives her the terrifying glare, since she's just looking right at him. Terrifying glare. Boo. Wait.
I've seen a couple of them just go up in flames, tore the crap out of one. I'm not really terrified of them.
Oh, I was scrolled all the way up. I'm like, something didn't work right. Well, that's my whole action. So you gotta at least like yawn or something. Well. So, like, bubbling up out of the ground. Like,
bubbling crude.
Bubbling up. You guys see, like, a cloud form, and it just, you could smell the sulfury smell, and, no, not a square, a circle. You know, pretty much all you guys, on the hill. Have to make a saving throw.
Okay.
It is going to be a Constitution saving throw.
Yeah. Okay.
For the record, I did not use my inspiration. I just marked it off because I don't get inspiration today.
You know, Sven, since you were late and we talked about that, I knew you would take your inspiration away as honesty, I will allow you have it.
Oh.
Because nice. I said it's the honor system, and I know Sven will take his away, and you totally did. Wait, unless you heard that on stream or something. I think that was before we started streaming. Let me put that circle back up, because can I get... Yeah, I can get you guys without getting my scarecrow. Saving a Constitution saving.
You know, throw? Hang on a second. No, I'm not going to use my. Maybe a mistake. Yes, I am. Never mind. I am going to use it. I mean,
well, did you had a click or you didn't?
I did.
I should have used it.
Dropped the I'm first two. Yes, I'm glad I did too.
Right, I dropped the first four. So.
All right, so a little bit of damage, but the whole area is a poisonous yellow-green fog centered on pretty much... we should put that on here, huh?
I'm going to use, as a reaction, my... what the hell is it called? You know... shit, let me find it.
Shit. As you find that...
Stone's Endurance. Stone's Endurance, which will negate...
I'm going to re-roll.
It will negate 3 points of that damage that I took.
That's it?
Ooh. Well, it's a one. It's a 1d12.
Are we... Boo. Have other... Are we spewing and nauseous and stuff, or is it just...
Damage? The... I was trying to get there... it's a fog. The area is heavily obscured, so you're all blinded.
The damage only occurs when you enter it for the first time on your turn or start your turn there.
Yeah. Right? So just...
Or cloud kill.
Just save that damage.
Yeah, we're going to start at a turn there anyway. So.
That's right. Yeah.
So just save that damage for your turn. We're just getting it out of the way.
So with a 16 save, I'll use my lucky feat to try all to right, save so, from spewing. Although I am a cat, I should get a bonus because I'm used to retching.
Natural.
A lot of experience with hairballs.
And...
You're probably used to it now. You also inherited Rob's hairballs.
Yes. Spock and Kirk.
No, she's going to get behind the hut. The skull drops behind the hut, so you can't really see it anymore back there. You don't care. Fireball doesn't need to be seen. Oh, the hut gets to go. The hut's not waiting on her, though. Screw you. I'm going this way. And this hut doesn't have any mobility issues, so... It's going to move 30 feet this way. And it is going to target... said person that burned me with rock. Fireball and 120-foot range rock. Here, hold this.
Jeez, a 30?
Does AC 30 hit?
Nope. Yeah.
You're like, wait,
out of
what
the
is
shield
that?
That one.
Yeah, shield.
Maybe a 10th level shield.
Boom! Not too bad. Could have been worse. 18 points of damage.
Yeah, only half my hit points.
Good thing fireball is not concentration.
Yes.
And you see it like pull out another one out of the muck. This one might be a statue head or something, you know. It's a big rock.
Nice.
But the way I read it, it can only do that once. Raukenya. I mean, one
this thing ran up to me. I'm going to shift a little bit out of the cloud after I get burned by it.
That spell's kind of a shitty spell. Just had a long range. It would be great if you couldn't move, right? Like you're in a room or something.
Correct. It is pretty awesome. Now, one of them moves, too. I don't remember which one it is, but one of them moves. Every
that one can move. You can blow it with wind, all that kind of crap. So my fifth level spell just got eradicated by gust of wind.
Yeah, so eyes are watering too much, and I just can't see it.
Wow.
Two attack. That hits. Offhand. I saw it just scraping at it and using some of the straw to wipe the stuff off my fur and hair.
Grimfoot Thunder Song.
Whoa, my whole map just went almost completely flat. Okay, that's cool. I need to move this way anyway. I'm going to move. I take my cloud kill.
You take your damage. See, it was already like, you know, now you can roleplay it. You can't see either. You're like,
let's see. Hang on. Before I get that far, let me check. Yeah, I'm looking at my range is. Well, yeah.
That'd be out of the cloud.
That's 40. Okay, I'm going to carelessly attack or recklessly attack with a javelin at the hut thing.
So your G-string comes
G-string
untucked.
You guys see Grim kind of tuck his knees together, you know, he's got his feet out, his knees tucked together. I am going to recklessly attack with a second javelin, which I don't know why I had that. Okay, there we go. I don't, and it should have recklessly attacked. It didn't.
What's the range of a javelin?
That's right. Try 30. Okay.
It would have balanced out.
Unfortunately, no special effects. But I will continue my move. And for some reason, I can't move my toe. To right. Okay, down arrow.
All right, this thing looks like it's coming right for us. Yeah, so, you know what? Frost is going to use Spirit Guardians. So if it does come over here, it's going to take some damage. So I think, let's see, it's this one. And then I click that one. Okay, so that should do it. And, can I... I only see a red X, so I don't know if you see the... when I'm trying to move, sorry. I was going to move up. All right. Thank you. And then Spiritual Weapon, let's attack this guy.
You might have had to do that in a different order, but okay. Like, get out of the burning, smoking, coughing.
Oh, sure, sure. Yeah,
then
yeah.
Cast the spells, right. But yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. That's enough.
All right, Sir Chan Destroy is going to choke a little bit.
He opens his eyes. Grimfoot. He's like,
"What
I still
the
can't
fuck,
see.
Grimfoot?
I had a blind sight though. I can move 10 feet."
Grimfoot ripped a nasty fart. So he's going to move. he'll move down to there.
I think that's what dream pastries, what happened from eating too many dream pastries.
And he's going to attack this scarecrow.
Cloud I've got farts. Bubble guts. So Ren, well, Kenya would definitely be doing that. Can we weaponize it? Can we choose when to do it?
Can we fart into a beaker?
I'll go put my mask back on.
Man, there's this YouTube short I was watching yesterday, and this guy walks bitch crazy. Like, Happy Thanksgiving, Grandma. And she's sitting there. Oh, I'm so glad you could come. She's got oxygen on. And he walks over, and it's like it's him filming. And he walks over, and he squats down by her oxygen machine. Goes, rips it. And his brother goes, or somebody goes, oh man, you got to come on, grow up. And then all of a sudden you hear grandma goes, what is it?
I saw that where he went down the hallway and farted into the oxygen machine.
Yeah.
Burp, you know, the hoses all run down the hallway. That's a dick move there.
It's worse than a Dutch oven.
Right? What do you call that?
Doing it wrong. You should see a doctor.
Did it take damage? I did take damage.
That's called when you do it to grandma. It's called a Dr. Kevorkian.
I'm done with this stupid spiritual weapon thing, and all these other spiritual things flying around. You know, I'm just going to claw on this guy. Not his hand falls off. Like, he's like, oh! He reaches down, picks it up, puts it on this other. Claws with the other hand. Or maybe he claws with the hand he just picked up. Yeah, that's what happens. He's like, he can't get through his armor. That was lame. My last attack with scarecrows, and I can't even hit with it. Oh, I might.
You should have given him. Should have given him guns like the scarecrow from Wizard of Oz.
I'm trying to figure out
guns. What scarecrow are you watching?
No, I'm serious. The scarecrow in Wizard of Oz has a gun.
Like, the OG one.
Which version?
Yeah. Hold on. I'll find a screenshot.
All right. This may be useless, but this giant treehouse, I want to cast Dispel Magic on it.
Okay.
The hell's he got a gun for?
He does, yeah. That's awesome.
I remember something like that.
Since apparently it's not in the book, but the movie definitely has a gun.
It's not canonical with the book.
Right. I know there was the scene where they were doing snow coming down and it was fluffed asbestos.
Really?
All the actors, yeah. Sitting there. Fluffy clouds of asbestos.
I gotta read Dispel Magic. You got that right there?
Yeah, I do.
Is it, can you share? Is there Karen or share? I'm getting it. Dispel. Oh, you got it.
Creature, object, or magical effect. Hopefully this thing is affected by Dispel Magic. Otherwise, I've just wasted it. But... even my fireball barely did one drop, so I can't catch both of them in the same fireball for a second fireball.
I'm reading, so that's yep. Why I'm looking off, waving there. Okay. I dislike when they say you have to look in this section and then they didn't link the section. Why didn't you just link it right there?
Well, I think it whatever spell she used to animate the thing, it'd just be a contested roll. If it's above third level. I'm sure it is.
I think it's a construct, so it would probably have some kind of a saving throw, spell DC saving throw, and then if it's not a construct, then it'll do nothing. I know a lot of golems have anti-magic trait, so it doesn't work on them. But
That's right.
Anti-magic.
I might have to break out the module.
Does the hut's stat block not say anything?
It refers to what I'm looking for in the special event. Okay, here it is. Never mind, I found it. Below, and then I had to go like freaking three clicks below. Okay. Oh, not that. There we go. Yeah, I don't think it's going to really do anything to it. Dispel magic on a construct. Does dispel magic
magical construct?
It is a magical construct.
I assume it would have some effect on it, but
insta kill.
I mean, if the stat block doesn't have any information on it, then you can rule it however you want to rule it.
Well, roll whatever you're supposed to roll anyways. A 26 is pretty high. It doesn't have any effect. It doesn't even slow it. It's like, huh? Unusually emaciated? Where the hell's this guy? You're gonna move up. He's gonna get right to the edge. And he's gonna look menacingly and use his terrifying gaze.
Is that RuPaul?
Someday. Alice. Who knows the rest?
All right, so
Rokenya.
I'm going to use my feline agility and jump across here. Oh, I was doing the math, forgetting that this grid is not accurate. So let's see. That's 20. Okay, so I can get to there. 60. Yeah, I'm going to do it anyway. And then I'm going to run and jump onto the hut. And I'm getting out, as my object interaction, getting out my alchemist fire.
Nice.
Legolas. Was Finn here when there are cages full of ravens that were squawking, like trapped ravens on this walking hut.
On the hut itself, okay.
Yeah, they're like these cages of ravens, and when we showed up, they started squawking and stuff. So we figure they're probably captured.
I get a fire show and a snack.
So are you like trying to get up in the
on the roof.
On the roof of the hut.
There's a climb speed if I need it, but I'm also just gonna be jumping.
There's a green light coming out of the hut.
Knock on the door.
Knock on the door. You also maybe hear a baby crying inside?
Odd. Okay.
Is it Grimfoot?
I mean, the ravens are making all kinds of noises, but I think you can hear crying? I think you can hear Fireball? Why not?
It's a high level baby.
Yeah. As coming out from behind the hut is this flying skull, and you see like a little shriveled up hand reach out of the top and like and a fireball goes off. Boom.
And
hits and also ignites the poisonous gas, which burns in a non-harmful bluish light for a quick second. It looks kind of cool. As your eyeballs catch on fire from a fireball. Like that?
I'm outside the fireball.
I didn't have you targeted, did I? Oh, yeah, I did. Drop you out of the target. It's a new fireball. It has, like, embers that fall out on top of burning cats.
Nice.
Hey, guys, go. Sorry, Scarecrow. Did I get
everybody? Oh, dang!
Rost, your spirit guardians go down as you fall unconscious. And a burning scarecrow falls on top of you. Nah.
Ouch.
You're taking D6 damage per round. How does that work with your death saving throws?
Not well, I'm sure.
I'm sure.
Auto fail.
Yeah. Grimfoot.
All right. So that guy's gone. All right. So I'm going to turn to this one and step a little bit closer because not to scale. There we go. And, attack it with the blood spear.
Doesn't have any blood, so it doesn't work. Gotta attack him with the straw spear.
Straw spear.
Have you been using a spear?
Yeah.
Have you killed anything with it?
I just did just now, the first time I've been trying to. Okay. Caesar's been kill-stealing me every chance he gets. And he just laughed. And Gorgio does that shit, too. He's like, yeah. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, and items. So
Javelda took one. To be back to back.
Javelda took a lot with her fireball.
A player that has gotten the blood spear. And did you have it last time, too?
I think I did. I think
Storm had the blood spear. I think
Storm
so.
Had the blood spear. Yeah.
You didn't use it much because you had like a +3 something or another. A potion of greater healing like for Ross. Up. What? How'd that happen? Smithster, 77.
Thank you.
Cheater in chat.
And then I will move right over here.
Oh.
Wow. That's pretty good.
And I will end my turn there.
Oh. Well.
Don't forget, I'm on top of it.
Yeah, I know you're on top of it, and I don't want you on top of me, so I'm going to smack you.
We use Javelda's shield. Get a +5 tomorrow.
Give him a spanking.
I'm also going to move up, too, to I don't have to move up nowhere. I'm going to stay right over here and reaching out from the muck and under the mirror, this thing has deep roots that can reach way out. And attack you guys. So the first one takes a swing with one of the branches at Javelda. Oops, I only meant to roll that once. We'll take the first one. Oh. That was a crit, right? Or was that the second
one? I'm going to use my luck point.
Yeah, you had Javelda and Rokinya targeted?
Oh, is that what happened?
Yeah.
Aha!
Yeah, Rokinya got a crit hit.
Yeah.
So your luck point makes that a just a regular roll or another roll? Or I forgot. You did too.
allows you to you just been really look okay. Looking for the actual to roll an additional d20, and you can choose which one of the rolls you pick. So I'm going to choose, so she rolls another d20, and then I'm going to choose the not critical one.
I wonder if I roll another critical, though. Is that okay?
You can choose the first or the second crit.
That's right.
I still hit. But you're fortunate it wasn't a crit. As this thing goes, like you're up on the roof and it just like swipes this branch across, whoop, hits you for a lot of damage. Poof! Squishes Rail Kenya. Nice.
So squish. Do I drop and does the alchemist fire shatter? All over me in the house?
Yes. If you'd like. Multi-attack. Second attack is gonna be on Grimfoot. As out of the ground swirls up some roots and branches and AC 30 as Grim gets hit.
Damn.
For 33 points of damage. Wow. 11 because he absorbed.
Nice.
A potion of greater healing for Relkenya? Well, that's good timing. Because Relkenya's got a rock coming at her.
I'm on top of the house.
Not Relkenya. I'm sorry. Sorry. Javelda. I don't know why I get your name mixed up.
That's a straight. That's a small straight, man.
So I get a bonus.
Big rock. Attaboy. Flying through the air. AC 30. That's my magic number to hit today.
It is.
Bludgeoning damage. Boom. Rokinius, Javelda's down. Rost. Things are switching quickly to looking ugly.
Yeah, that's not great. I can heal Javelda from back here. This is gonna make Sven cringe, but I'm gonna healing word Javelda from here.
You don't want to take two rounds to move and do it. Cure light next round.
There you go.
Thank you.
A little bit of healing. And then I will just toll the dead at this thing, I guess.
Oh, wait, you're prone. Hold on.
Yeah. I would like to stand up, too. Thank you.
Exhausted, though. Changes the thought process of being unconscious, that's for sure.
That's good. All right, Sacred Flame, because I clicked the wrong button, but it works. So, I accidentally cast the wrong spell in my confusion with everybody dying around me. But it works anyway. Pass. There we go.
All right, search and destroy.
Well, search and destroy is going to touch himself for some lay of hands. and get back 10. Oh, I can't change the wounds. Oh, no, hold on.
You got to do it on your, You tried to do it from the combat tracker.
Well, I had my number lock turned off.
Oh. I try to do it as a player on the combat tracker, and I'm like, I can't.
And then he's going to...
Do it from your character sheet. I don't think as a player you could do it from the combat tracker, can you?
I don't think so. He's going to move down to there.
This poison gas is all burned off, so...
Now his armor's all muddy.
Grimfoot farts are gone.
Top of the round. Break time.
Break time.
Yeah, 1 second. There's still a scarecrow alive? Oh my god. We gotta go to break so I can at least try to scratch somebody or that guy when I get back. Alright, so we're gonna take a 10-minute break. I'm gonna set a timer over here for 44. 44, and I'm going to put the slideshow on, and we're going to get a drink and all that stuff. So you got 10 minutes. We'll be back, though, for the second half, so hurry up. All right, we're getting back. Did you notice we got an extra minute? I was like, I need one more minute. What? What do you want? You want to say hi to everybody? Girl, you just seen what I was eating, huh? Okay. Go lay down. All right, so top of round five. The skinny one. This guy is attacking Grim. Claw. Miss. Multi-attack, I get two claws. Okay, I'm clawing somebody. Claw.
Yes!
Did it work? Can I claw you?
Yeah.
Slashing.
Yes. 3 points. I scratched somebody with a scarecrow. I'm excited.
I don't think I did it yet. And you got to make a wisdom saving throw or be frightened. But are you raging still? We don't care.
Yes. I'm raging.
All right. Rost.
I'm talking like Relkina. Raging. Raging.
All right.
Did you catch yourself on fire, Rel Kenya? No.
Not yet.
Decided against that idea.
Not yet. All right. We'll see how that goes. I think Grim needs a little healing, so I'm going to come up behind him. And
oh, yeah.
Just stay where you are and do word of healing.
Yeah, that's great.
Just throw good berries at him.
Just one at a time, every turn. One good berry.
Hey, man, he's as good as a shepherd at catching crap. Out of the
a chocolate payday? You're a turd. I saw one of those at the store the other day. I'm like, should I? No.
Why, thank you. Thank you very much.
Welcome. Bonus action. We've got this thing is going to come up here and... attack this scarecrow.
What? I don't know.
What? Oh, did it? It just didn't
big
work
X.
Or something.
The only thing I could weird. Hit was the big, right. Big X.
Spiritual weapon.
At least I knew where you wanted it.
Miss. Okay.
I guess if we, oh crap! The hut goes. This sucks. Is Chevalda conscious?
She is probably still prone. She hasn't had a chance to
yeah, but is she
have a
conscious?
Turn since she is conscious.
Chevalda, you cast a spell magic on this thing and it didn't work. And you're like thinking, wait, maybe this thing's has something to do with that pine cone, green glowing stone.
Maybe.
So maybe if you could cast a spell magic on that.
Well, it'd be great if I had another casting of a third level spell, but.
Or if you knew where, if you could. See
or if
that,
I knew where that
right?
was.
Right.
But, yeah. So.
But this thing don't care, because it's gonna smash somebody.
I bet you
face.
Don't give a shit.
Rokenya, you are unconscious. Just lying there, are you still prone, lying on the roof? Is that where you're at?
Correct.
What's this thing's intelligence?
As if I'm not unconscious, I am conscious.
Its intelligence is extremely, extremely low. It's just smashing stuff. So... It smashed you, and you're not moving. It's moving forward. Right? I thought I saw it can move. If this thing can't, oh yeah, it can move 30 feet. I'm like, this changes the whole game, the whole combat if this thing can't move. But yeah, it can move. So it just kind of shifts up, but it's got a 60-foot reach with its multi-attack. So, yeah, I'm going to go. Javelda's on the ground, so I can't really see her anymore. So the first attack's going to be on Grim. A plus 12 to hit, guys, is no joke. Smashes Grim with one of its roots, doing 36 points of damage, 18 because he's resisting it. Boom! The second one's on the Ross.
Wow, man.
Oh my god.
Holy crap.
Well, don't say it like that because the third one's on you. I do get three, right? The hut makes three attacks with its roots. It can replace one of these attacks with a rock attack. Well, I'm getting you the root attack, not the rock attack. Oh, that was almost a miss. Some bludgeoning damage to search and destroy. And he goes down by 19. Wow. You're pretty wounded, huh?
Yep. All
right, Ralkenya. You're on the roof of this thing.
Laying there. Rachel grabs a flask and just dump it all over the top of this thing. And so at the start of each of its turns, it will take 1d4 damage. Use that again if you want it. And then I'm going to get up from prone. I did not move for a whole round, so I might get my feline agility back. And I'm going to jump onto this thing. One thing, a difficult terrain. That's 20. Come on. That map, there it is.
Oh, using them up. There. Potion of Greater Healing for Search and Destroy. Faltrex.
Donka.
It kind of be what? One more left, maybe? I don't remember how many I got. So you're, are you disengaging? Or are you just hoping he doesn't have attack of opportunity?
He has a 60-foot reach, so.
I know, right? Yeah, well, your character doesn't know that. That's
that
cheating.
60-foot...
That's metagaming. No, it's true.
Wow, look at that.
What? Nice, thanks.
Yahtzee.
I like you get max healing and exhaustion. That should be a thing. Huh. All right, Grim.
Okay.
You're like, ow?
Yeah, ow indeed.
You can't even tell that this thing's even wounded. Like, is it Is that the broken branch over there? I don't know what's going on with this thing.
Well, I see some smoke on the roof.
What is that?
Yeah, I mean, if I was not raging and was like some other class, I'd probably say it's time to retreat. But I am raging, and I will attack this guy here.
How's this guy still alive?
I don't know.
There's carnage, bodies everywhere, scarecrow stuffing, and there's this one guy just standing there still. Hey!
He hadn't even been hit.
I'm not even wounded yet, right? And he was like one of the OG originals.
All right. It's round five. Okay, so you guys see these.
He's still up.
And my undead ancestors come swooping out.
They look different now, though.
Harry and these guys, yeah.
They look more...
They look different there.
Barovian.
Barovian.
All right. Yeah, he don't know anything else to do except come over here and hit this thing.
Well, he probably wants to stand up first, right?
Oh, yeah. So he's only got 15.
And it's difficult terrain.
So he's going to stand up and
get up on this little hill.
And he's going to lay some hands again. Another 10. Let me pass my turn.
All right. Javelda is going to stand up and very seriously contemplate running.
She already started. She's way back there. She's already backed up as far as she can.
But she knows if she's on her own, she's not likely to survive very long.
Especially if she's got to freaking make a fire. She hates doing that.
Oh, making fires is easy. She's got
collecting wood part. That's what she doesn't like.
Yeah. Doing. This thing is just too overpowering for all of us.
It's a tough. Tough encounter.
This is beyond.
I remember how I solved it when I was in the game, but
I'm just gonna get rid of that one because three up.
Oh, that's probably gonna toast him. Yeah. Flaming scarecrow. La 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 la.
Grim roars. Ah!
My bad.
How tall is that thing?
How tall is the hut?
Yeah, like, you know. Can you run up that leg right there? Could a person run up that thing?
Can you climb onto a creature larger than yourself? Yes.
Okay. Be a climbing thing. Okay.
It is... I didn't say exactly how tall, but it's a 15-foot square. The hut is, and it's on top of the stump that's got these long-ass legs. So I'm going to say this thing's like 60 feet up in the air, the top of it, when it like stands up, you know what I mean? There's like windows and a door. But it is the floaty skull occupant's turn. So, what's the range of this? 30. She got hit by a fireball, so she's a little skittish at the moment until she sees what's going on. I think she's
that was like 18 seconds
to...
ago.
Yeah. Oh, you mean the old lady floating in the head?
Yeah.
In the skull?
I think she's going to cast a spell on herself. So let me burn that spell slot. And down arrow. Javelda.
Last to first. Well. Let's get a little closer. See if that puts me in range. Yeah, I'm going to try and firebolt the skull.
Or the skull.
The skull for now. I can't see her.
110 feet? Yeah, you can. You can make her head out. She's got like 3/4 cover. Are you trying to get... Ooh, just got raided by Scarlet Watch. What's up, guys? Chris is Strahd.
Yeah, if I can target her, I'll give her a toll to dead.
All right there.
Nope,
there
that's
go.
A range of 60. Nah, I'm gonna have to target the skull because 3/4 cover. There's no way I'll be able to hit it.
There you go. Not with a 4.
Nope.
Can't roll better than a 4. Rost.
All right, guys, I think it's time we go out of here. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm still going to, though, bonus action and at least attack this thing, the hut, with my spiritual weapon. Let's see
it's
if that
not,
does anything.
It's not Jabba. It's his cousin.
It's Pizza the Hut.
Lasagas. Hut. Creeping hut. Spiritual
okay.
Weapon, 6 points. Look! You can't tell it did any damage. You're like, did I break a branch?
Just bounced off of it.
Is that a bird's nest that it broke?
And I'm going to heal Grimfoot again. Oh, that was terrible. And then I'm going to start running.
Go good.
Now remember, you provoke attacks of opportunity if you leave it 60-foot reach.
Okay, got it. I'll keep that in mind. That's my first concern. I think that's as far as I can make it.
Yeah, you didn't make it far enough. It's on fire!
It's on fire!
Wait, why is there two... You did get it on yourself. You spilled it on yourself. You took 2 points of fire damage. Wait, why does it say...
No, it says Baba Lasagna.
Do you have it on there twice, maybe?
I only see once, but...
I only see once, too. That's weird.
1d4. Not like it's going to cripple it.
Yeah, but why did it do it twice, though?
It's just never going to stop, so.
I don't know.
Eventually, by this time tomorrow, it'll be dead.
Eventually. No, you guys will be dead long before it will, because now it's its turn, and it gets 3 attacks. Ross is like, I meant to go on the other side of the hill, so I didn't see me. Are you within its reach?
Right. Probably.
Why can't I? Why isn't it working right?
Oh, I'll just skip it and come back to it next turn.
Oh, why isn't it working right? Because you're pushing the wrong damn button.
Yeah.
All right, so the first attack is going to be on Grimfoot. That's a hit. Down goes Grimfoot. Second attack, search and destroy. I think you guys be buying disadvantage or something for this thing's freaking.
He's got a plus 20 to hit, so what's
this? It's only
plus
12.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it hit me with a 17, so it had to have rolled low. It rolled a 5. You know, it's plus 12.
Down goes search and destroy. Might be making up new characters. Third attack, still within 60. I'm going to give you minus 5 to hit because you're down the hill. How's that?
Sure. I won't say no.
And I rolled a 14, 21, still hits. And down goes Ross.
Oh, man.
Crunch, 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 crunch. It moves up a little and looks at Javelda. And we're okay, yeah.
All right, so I'm going to wiggle my fingers a little bit and it's going to become silent over there.
She is mumbling some crap over there. You can hear her. Damn freaking ravens, though. Instantly goes quiet.
So I can't put the effect on whoever's in there, but that probably doesn't matter. And then I'm going to...
Her?
Going to run along the roof. I mean, the ridge of this ruin, and then jump into the water.
500-year-old ruins you're running on the roof of? Like, rusty nail, ow! Rusty nail, ow!
And,
You don't. So you do like stone.
They're using stone and
give
nails
me
and stone.
A Constitution saving throw. All right, you failed. You have to use all of your movement to jump into the water because you're a cat. Okay. And you'd be like,
I don't know how deep it is at this point, but if it is deep enough, I'm going to try to submerge myself so I can't be seen.
Okay, it's only deep enough if you lay prone.
If I'm able to, yes, that's what I'm going to
yeah.
do.
Yeah, you get a little straw.
Okay, and then the deactivated. I was going to say that emboldening bond should be gone. It is.
As soon as you like,
so that's it.
You know, like hit the water, splash, and you can see like the waves like stir up all these like nests of flies that are like. Bzzz.
Lovely. That sounds like a later me problem.
That sounds like a, I don't know if I could stay right here in a very long, or I'm going to get stung. So I'm silenced? I don't like to be silenced. How do you unsilence a silence? Dispel magic?
Presuming she...
No.
I mean, she would know what happened, but she doesn't know what the range is, where it is around her.
Yeah.
But you can't. But you just have to get out of it.
If your flying freaking jetmobile requires verbal commands to move, then you're screwed, aren't you?
Yeah.
Kinda, yeah.
I don't know how this thing works.
Wait till the spell ends.
I'm just thinking, right? How does this giant skull work? Let's see.
So you're going to have to get out of the skull and run.
Let me see. I got to research this thing because, you could have just... I mean, I'm imagining she's up a little bit off the swamp, too. I was thinking she's like 15 feet up. I don't have it indicated there, but... Where the hell... Let me read this. No, it's not on there. It's going to be in the encounter here. Hold on.
Dig through the ditches and burrow through the witches.
It says it hovers in place until Baba Salaga commands it to fly, which she can do while inside it. It sounds to me like she's got to talk to the damn thing, doesn't it?
She's got to command it, yeah?
No one else can control the skull. She get 3/4 cover.
That's cool. Wasn't expecting that minor bonus. If we were all alive, it would make a difference.
It She's might, like, yeah.
It's pretty cool. I didn't want her blasting us as we trying to get away.
She can't even. She doesn't want to get in the swamp.
Why should she live here?
Exactly.
She has a flying skull.
She can press the digitate herself clean if she needs to.
She can yell for her hut to come get her.
What's this do? I know that. All right. Cantrip? No one's close enough. All right. She is going to... dodge for now. Search and destroy. I don't like it. Why don't you just tell all the other players that your character is going to survive?
Oh, that's only one, isn't it?
Right, but no one else should know that but you and you alone.
19. He should get a bonus for that. He should get one hit point. So or 23.
Everyone gets announced. The music plays. You make the saving throw. Oh, he's fine. He's fine. I'm just going to start smashing people that are unconscious. Then I'll have to
next time. Next time I'll just say dun dun dun.
Right? I like it where you try to hint at your players. Oh, you see him? He's really coughing up blood now. Right. All right, Grim. Cool. What are you doing? For some reason
make a
turn?
Death saving throw. I guess.
Yeah, that's all you do.
Do I do that? It does it automatically, doesn't it?
It was automatic.
You got a 23.
You 19.
That's what we were just talking about. But, do you cough up blood?
Pass it.
Just don't. Don't fart again.
I fart.
Absolutely fart.
All right, Rao, Kenya.
Nice. All right, so I'm going to try to. If I stay under the water and just follow the river, if I can't, then I'm going to get up enough to where I can see what I'm doing to get into the deeper river to where I can do that.
The river and its deepest in the middle is 10 feet. Like, it's a and it's not like totally. So you can't get completely.
I use my claws submerged.
To. But this
scrape along the bottom. I've got enough weight in my backpack and stuff. I'm sure I'm evil. I can just move along the bottom.
I think
it's half speed.
I think you're gonna have disadvantage on any charisma based checks right now because you're wet pussy.
Okay. That's all I do.
I mean, you know how pitiful he's gotta look.
Move in action.
Drowned cat.
Some people find it endearing.
Uh-oh.
Critical failure. Ouch.
Rust.
Fucking heel. Rust.
His spleen falls out of his mouth.
Yeah, potion of heal for Rust.
Thanks.
Your spleen bursts open and a potion of healing falls out. Oh, the hut gets to go.
Uh-oh. I actually don't have that on my sheet. Does somebody have it readily available?
Yeah, since you're feeling sadistic and want to masochistic, I want to have the hut pound you to death.
I mean, it's... Yeah, this is going to go great, guys.
It's like a word of healing. What you guys love, so there you go.
So the hut, looks around. None of one's attacking it, right?
It's on fire. No one around it is alive, really.
Yeah. So
it's like, there's still people that have attacked
it. Doesn't something. Like, I mean, does but, it look? I mean, it, I guess it can look, right? Like, it's windows and it's.
I assume door. It has vision.
And it just stands there. Grimfoot. I wonder if you made that or not.
I can see it.
We heard it. My complaint is I have it turned on and it should not be turned on. I think only the player should know by seeing the little checkbox.
Right. So I twitch. I'm not dead yet. I'm not dead.
He's a goner.
Javelda, you're like. If I run, this thing might see me.
Yeah.
Are you prone? No.
No.
You're just squatting.
Yeah. I really don't have any good options.
Give me a perception check.
All right.
You don't hear these ravens anymore?
Terrible.
No, Javelda got a random magic item.
Uh-oh.
Who knows? Who knows? Yeah.
Could be. Anti-hut.
Yeah.
It could be the staff that you guys destroyed that would have taken out this hut in one hit.
It's a missile launcher.
Do you need the table?
No.
Only good against huts.
Yeah,
right.
Perfect. Exactly what we needed.
All those ravens in there in the cage. Remember them? Yeah, right.
Yep. I'll be friends with them in a minute.
A little picture of a squirrel on the side of it.
Is the hut considered an animal?
Do you, party sheet.
I bet if we summoned Clyde, he would kill it.
It's allergic to poo.
What happened? I don't have any way to heal anybody. So Javelda's gonna take off.
It's in the party sheet.
She's probably gonna die, but she's gonna try and take off.
Is she disengaging, or this thing's gonna see her and it's got reach?
She doesn't really know its reach.
She's seen Ross get smacked down below the bottom of the hill.
Yes.
Or maybe she might have been unconscious when that happened.
I think she was unconscious when that happened. She was down.
She starts booking it?
Yeah, she's going to book it.
Well, this thing doesn't even react to her. She goes running off.
You did see me jump into the water, so.
Yeah, I probably did at that.
But Norse don't swim. Gnorse.
That's right.
Yep. Like it's Dwarves. Gwarf. Come on.
All right.
Dwarves.
Search and destroy. Did he make it? We don't know. Just take your point of exhaustion and die. He's dying. That was top of round 8, by the way. You got another little checkbox down there, but on the other side.
Should exhausted affect a death save?
Or did he die?
No, it's just one
thing. He failed a death saving throw, yeah. He's still exhausted, so he had a minus one on the roll, I think.
Right. But it shouldn't.
No, he would have disadvantage for exhaustion. Doesn't dog exhaustion give you disadvantage?
Not on your
disadvantage on exhausted checks. Minus one.
Right.
That's saving throw.
So it shouldn't give you a.
Yeah, give me a minus one.
I don't think death saving throws are ability checks though, right?
I don't think so. Still a 7, though. I mean, it's still a
5. I mean, you still failed, but I don't know why I gave you the minus 1, though. That's kind of weird. All right, Ross, what are you doing there, laying weird on the ground behind this hill? All
right.
You see Givalda just take off running with her little legs.
I want to heal one of these guys, and so I don't metagame. I'm gonna roll a die and see which one of these guys I'm going to heal.
The same distance.
So I'm going to... heal search and destroy. From there.
That's just the way you do it. You say, I'm not going to show favorites, so I'm just going to roll a die. And then just don't tell anybody what the die roll means.
Yeah.
Just pick the one you wanted anyway.
Hi, right? I'm going
to. Sorry.
Hi,
you want me to,
high is
going to
be
back
that guy, and low is going to be that guy. Okay,
tell you what I was assigning it. Because I can do that. That's fine.
You're fair. It's fair.
I mean, if you're trying to be fair.
I just say going clockwise 1, 2, 3, 4, and then don't tell him where to start.
All right.
Yep.
So I'm gonna heal him.
I just picked the character that I think the player's doing a better job running. That's how I do it.
Then
would have been dead a long time ago. No, I'm kidding.
I'm continuing. I'm crawling. I'm still prone. I'm not standing up. I'm going to crawl along, like, you know, in this ditch, basically, to try to keep out of sight of this hut. So hopefully it doesn't kill me.
That's weird.
Do you even look? You just do a low crawl, like totally, like, your helmet?
Oh, yeah. Just as low as I can go. I'm not looking back.
Low crawl.
And
I've been there. I've done that. Bullets flying over my head. Yep. Low crawl.
I can I'll take a double move actually and move up to there.
Well, my character sheet it changed the max hit points.
It's a bonus action spell.
Oh.
So
you now totally 100% have muck in your pants.
That's fine. Can I roll to see if I like it?
You 100% don't, trust me. There's no way
okay.
You would like it. Wait, you could be a Marine, though. They like that
shit.
It's not
that we like it, it's that we're used to it. It feels odd without it.
They preferred it, right? At airborne school, I was in my unit with three Force Recon Marines, and they aim for the big puddle in the middle of the drop field. Like, why did you aim for it? They're covered in mud.
Because it's great!
All right, Grim. Are you alive? Did you...
I think so.
Made yeah. three saves. He's stabled. So
he's stabled. Yeah, he's like, I'm just laying here.
Room full of horses.
And then you see, like...
You guys see his toe twitch.
You see, like, this swarm of flies just kind of, like, settle down on top of his unconscious, stable body. Maybe they won't bite you. Maybe they will. It's just burning. It's all it's doing. It's just sitting there burning. It's not even moving. Rokinya,
so I'm going to work my way over to the other side of the road, of the river, and
give me a survival roll.
Skill. Here we go.
Almost. You almost got a fish.
Okay. A three-eyed fish.
This is perfectly clean swamp water.
All right, and I'm going to look around, see if I can see anybody else from my thing. That was... What are you talking about? Have I used
over here? You so would you would have access to the ravens. Agility.
Why isn't it letting me move? Come on.
Where do you want to move? Like further in?
There we go. Oh, did it for a second.
I moved you.
There we go.
You want to just point? Way. Okay, there you go. Remember, there's a circle of stones over here.
Yes, but I don't need to remind it of that. My other party who's going the opposite direction needs to remember that.
How long does silence last?
A minute, I think. I'll double check that, but... Concentration up to 10 minutes.
She's stuck there for 10 minutes. Cursing silently.
What is that, 600 rounds?
It's 10 minutes. It's like a short bus ride. She's thinking. She's like, is that the spell, silence?
Yes.
And that's a... All right, she climbs down, drops into the muck. I think that's about all she could do. So let's make this like this, and let's put it up like 15 feet, and she's on the ground now. For those that can see her.
So at this point, I'll be able to see. I'm going to call out to Javelda. Make sure that she sees me. We can meet up.
Yep.
Would I see Rost?
Crawling away, pretending to be prone.
He's not
like 50 feet away.
He's not That's actually trying to be stealthy. He's just trying to stay low. So yeah, you more hear him than anything.
That distance over the sound of the river.
I don't know. Have you ever low crawled in all your gear? It's not a pretty sound. Trust me.
Javelda, hearing Relkenya, will attempt to cross the river.
Do you...
Whatever.
Do you have an oar?
I do not.
Then I guess you just float around in your ice boat.
Nope. Who, good was idea.
That? Was that John's
was
character?
Pinch. That was Pinch.
That was Pinch.
And he couldn't swim.
You just float around in your ice boat. All right, so you guys hook up over there. What's going on with the unconscious guys?
All right, well.
I'm unconscious. I don't know what's going on.
Yeah,
the hut's going to have its way with us, I guess.
The hut doesn't appear to be doing anything currently because its person that commands it is silenced. She has to verbally command it.
That's why we have a paladin. They can sacrifice themselves to rescue the person.
That's a clue that she just climbed down out of the giant. She's going to leave the silence rather soon.
All right.
Not that Ross could do anything about it.
Yeah, right. I see there's a potion of heal for Grimm in the chat.
There's still stuff left.
Which
there's still a potion of heal?
He's stable. He's like,
just, well, you know what? That might just save you guys then.
I was going to wait, play dead until the hut went away, and then I was going to crawl over and lay hands on him so he could get up and go.
She's gonna be out of that. Well, let's see. Yeah. Well,
I'm afraid to move till that hut moves.
It's Ross's turn, so let's start with that.
I will stand up and book it over here towards these guys. I don't know how far I can make it, Drake, with a double move.
45 feet. Running down that hill.
There.
Oh, you.
I'm heading towards those guys. Yeah. So I'm not trying to be stealthy anymore. I'm just splashing through the water.
Yeah. As you get about halfway across, you see like these little fish with little sharp, pointy little teeth, the quippers.
I hope they don't bite me because they'll probably kill me.
You've got armor on, you'll be fine.
They look like they got stirred up by somebody else doing a seven.
Neil's bleeding in the water.
All right, Grim. You're like, oh, I think I landed on my dream pastry. Damn it.
Well, too bad a dream pastry doesn't like give you an instantly long rest. But
an instant long rest.
An this instant isn't long rest. Rob's Remember channel. Rob Toohey's game? Yeah. Yeah.
Talking about disruption. I did it one time. Mark got so pissed.
Yeah. Graham's gonna look at Search and Destroy and he's gonna stand up, or he's gonna roll over and he's gonna look at him and he's gonna say, "Run." And he's gonna stand up. And bonus action rage. That's still on by chance? Let's see here.
Yeah, it is.
Take prone off, rage. I'm going to take that off and reset it. Not that it'll matter.
It will because it counts rounds.
Right. Well, yeah, but I don't expect the last 10 rounds. And as I rage...
I don't know. You expect ancestral... you to last one round if you attack this hut.
Well, the ancestral guardians will... I mean, we can't get away from her. I've used half my movement to stand. That means I got 20 feet. No. Oh, shit. Can I grab him? I can drag, push, pull. Is he on the ground still? Are you standing up?
No, I haven't had a turn. I'm still prone.
He's conscious.
Okay. So, I haven't used my action yet, but if I can run by and grab him and drag him down to the water.
Do the old predator thing, like cover him in blood? Like,
just run to the water as quick as we can, because that looks like the only way away from me. I don't know, it may be foolish, but that's where I'm headed, right down there. If he resists, then he resists. If not, I keep running. But, or if he does, I keep running.
No, I'll drag my ass.
Okay, and you drag your ass right down there. And that's all I can do.
See, then he can drag you on his turn.
The hut's just burning.
You know what? We got the same distance.
The alchemist fire is going to get the level.
Still only has one blood drop, but still.
Yeah, but if we keep going in this
time
order,
tomorrow.
Yeah, you get the alchemist fire is going to level up. Ah. So she comes scrambling out of the silence, and she casts a spell. What level? God, right? Dispel magic on it?
Yes. Dispel magic would dispel it. I believe it's automatic. I don't remember dispel magic.
Yeah, third level and lower. God. And
cool.
Burn that spell slot. Down arrow.
Sir Chan Destroy is going to stand up. So
this thing's starting. You can hear. I don't know. As soon as this silence is gone, you guys can hear her cackly voice that sounds like a bunch of ravens in a hut, but that's over here. Not quite the same.
He's going to grab Grimfoot and drag him as far as he can.
Just run. Just run.
So 45.
Are you carrying capacity? Are you reducing your movement because of extreme weight?
Let me see. What is it?
It's in the water, so he floats.
Yeah, he weighs less in the water. I can lift.
Scale mail doesn't
drag.
Weigh less in the water.
Can lift, push, and drag 480.
With disadvantage on your swim check?
Oh, 480, right? That's not bad.
I think you're much better off if you just leave Grimfoot to his own devices.
I can't leave him.
He only has to drag him 10 feet, and then he's in deep water. He's submerged.
So, I mean, technically you need to use your action to grapple, and then you can move.
So I can only go 15 then?
Well, he's already grappled by Dingus.
This is correct. That doesn't count.
Dingus.
Dingus is already holding
on
to him.
Okay,
so.
My next character.
He's got him by the loincloth, not the other way around. But yeah, you could drag him out in the water 15 feet.
Yeah.
Just let the tide take us. Just let the current take us. That looks pretty swift.
Yeah.
It's the speed of a swamp.
Of a swamp. Well, that's misleading.
But you guys are now in
almost
10 feet of water, so you can duck.
No, a little bit. It's like 5 feet deep there. All right, Ro, can you...
Almost 10 feet. Just round up.
So,
As I'm shaking, getting the water off and seeing where they are and trying to... I'll get my bow out.
Do you guys dip?
Yes.
All right. I'll let you guys... be 500 feet from here.
Nice.
When you guys catch up with one another.
Sweet.
So we'll just put you over here at the edge of the map, just for so you guys have a map and tokens and stuff.
Thank you, oh merciful one.
So I got something weird going on. When Valtrex healed me for the 5, it reduced my max hit points from 48 to 43. And changed my wounds to 43 as well on the character sheet.
I think the aid went off.
Aid spell dropped, which is 5 max hit point bonus.
Oh, because it's still 48 on the combat tracker.
Yeah.
Kind of weird.
So the character sheet will not show the effect that aid does. So it'll only show in the combat tracker instance.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
That's confusing.
All right, so you guys are out of
right
immediate danger, I guess.
Well, let's not do that again.
Let's go back to
so if you drop aid, do I go unconscious?
Yeah. You guys are a good ways from town. Let's bring up the ye olde map. I guess you're not too far from town.
Yeah, whose idea was it to go mess with a walking house?
2, 3, about 4 miles, I would say. What time of day is it? 2 p.m. And you got a long trek through the
muck. We'll be there in 2 hours.
We're going to take a short rest first.
Yeah.
Eat some of his pastries.
Short rest in this area provokes swarms of flies.
Said we were 500 feet away.
Yeah, this swamp.
Well, we'll move up the road for
a mile away. That's what I'm saying.
Let's keep going. Yeah.
If you move out of the swamp to take your short rest, then you should be okay.
Let's go here.
We'll get away from the flies.
That was my only alchemist fires. Anyone else have any?
No.
Nope.
So, you guys get a short rest.
All right.
No.
I'm going to cast.
So you find a little canopy under some trees. Get out of the dewy rain that's here, and set up a little campfire, you know, just a small one to heat up some, because you're all chilled, especially the ones that got in the water, because it's right at freezing. So several of you might be approaching hypothermia.
Is everyone using hit dice?
Mm-hmm. Wow, yes. We're all rolling ones. What the hell?
All right. Here's
my extension's working. All right.
Here's the chef feet too.
I got everybody. A max.
Nice. Thank you.
That was pretty good.
What did you make?
I'm still trying to make my dream pastry recipe. I'm just a man trying to make his Cinnabon. Way in the world.
So, you keep spare little children in your sack to grind their bones into meal as we go.
No, I'm trying to recreate it without the children, the child meat.
It doesn't have the same pizzazz.
It was the bones for the flour.
Yeah, it's been troublesome to recreate.
It has to be a child with a soul. That's one of the rules.
Yes, yeah, so you've been using wrong kids all this time.
Man,
soulless little bingers. No.
Stupid Barovian kids. Give me an outsider.
Can't wait till we get out of here so I can make proper dream pastries.
Let's go to town.
So what's the plan here? You guys are going to go back to Valaki? Like, with your tail under?
I think so.
Tucked under?
We're just going to...
Yeah.
You know, it's run away so you can fight another day, right?
Are only going to have Mofogan Ripple. That's it.
Mofogan Ripple. Life.
Number five.
We're going to have to walk slow because me and Ross are exhausted twice.
Yeah, wow. We're all freaking exhausted.
Yep.
Every single one person in the party is exhausted.
Yeah, but... We got two exhaustions, which is half speed.
This is when the random encounter is not going to be very fun, is it? Let's see what we got.
I don't know. I've got all my spell slots.
So. Damn it.
I've got 1/3 level back because of arcane recovery. I've got 1 fireball in me.
So, you guys just... missed a random encounter.
No, don't it.
Like,
we could have used that XP.
Right, I think we need it to level
look
up.
Look at all this wolf crap all over the road.
We got XP for surviving, right?
Yeah.
Dying.
I could delete
We killed a few scarecrows.
I could delete the encounter out of the party sheet. Failed.
Is we did kill happens? All the scarecrows. It was definitely an experience.
Yeah, we got the scarecrows.
We definitely learned something.
Right?
what'd we learn anyway?
Don't attack the hut.
Use silence early.
Leave them alone. Pretty good. Silence is golden.
Do you remember how we beat that?
I forgot about the hut. No, I forgot about the freaking hut. I remember a bunch of scarecrows, but I remember this was a nasty fight. But I couldn't remember what level we were.
Do you know why you forgot about the hut? Because Yezu took out the hut by himself.
What'd he do to it?
He snuck in and took the gem.
Yep.
That's what Raquel was animating, right? I mean,
Keener can do that next time.
It almost killed him, I think, because he had to fight the thing inside the mouth down the hole, and it was biting him or poisoning him or something. I don't remember, but
I remember it was a nasty fight.
So, yeah. Well, you didn't even fight the hut.
Yeah, but it was still a nasty fight for our group.
Well,
it was because I think we retreated. We went in there and got our asses kicked, and we retreated, and that's when Yazoo went back and stole the heart, or the seed, or whatever. I remember the scarecrows beating the shit out of us
the first time.
That may have been when you joined the party.
I
remember the witch and the scarecrows just beating our ass, man.
Yeah, she's a 16th level spellcaster too.
Like third level when we went in here. Oh yeah.
Third level.
Yeah, Venerick's like, yeah, okay.
There's no level restrictions on any of these encounters.
No, yeah. It's up to the DM.
If you're foolish enough
to
be over there, you're foolish enough to get killed.
The first time I ran this, two of my party members had Dimension Door, and so they Dimension Doored all four people just inside the hut. from, you know, 200 feet away. So they avoided, like, the whole encounter. It was hilarious.
Stop look him from what throwing I did, boulders at you. Get inside.
Yeah.
If you guys look at the battle map, the Berez battle map again, look.
I got to open it up again.
I don't see anything on it. I see Grim out in the water.
Oh, hold on. There you go.
Oh.
I see the hut.
Now I remember that image.
That's when you get pretty inside. Cool. Wait, is line of sight on? Here, I'll turn line of sight off so you can see inside.
Oh. I don't remember how we dealt with that, Matt, when you were damning us.
I don't remember either.
Maybe you guys went, screw that. One wine's good enough than none.
I think you guys did it, but I really don't remember it.
I remember coming here, but I don't have any recollection of how we proceeded.
Yeah. Or right, was so I know we this were. Is the second time I've had my ass kicked in this encounter.
Well, we're going to... What am I doing? I'm deleting NPCs. And I'm also... Oops.
Also, I don't care if we don't get enough experience, because Drake already said I level up at the next long rest.
Oh, yeah, I remember him saying that.
I heard that. Board.
There you go. Yeah.
Well, when you guys get back to Valaki, there's no long rests, so I don't know what you guys are going to do.
Die.
They're out of long rests.
No. Die. Fresh out.
Well... The only way that you could get a long rest in Valaki is you have to drink some wine. And it can't be a newly named wine. It has to be a long rest. And a level up?
Ma! You know, that's a big turnaround from thinking about my next character.
It is, right? That's D&D for you, right? Oh, we got back to town, and we crawl into bed, and we wake up the next morning, and we're 100% even better.
The superpower.
We leveled up. We're even better than almost dead 24 hours ago.
I was totally ready to make a new character.
I always do.
So what was the secret here? You just hit the level up button, right? It's been a while.
If you like that one, I still redrag mine like the old way.
Oh, does that still work? That's all I like to do then.
But I always drag it on the sheet. That way I always drag the right one. Like from the box. But with... the latest unlinked modules. I don't know. Apparently reading on the forums this last week has been a kind of a disruption. Fantasy Ground memory leaks and people complaining their games weren't running. So it was a good week not to have any games running.
Yeah. There was a lot going on.
We haven't had any issues tonight. I haven't. Have you guys?
No.
I haven't had any errors or anything. No lag.
Oh, nice. Aura of protection. That didn't work.
Level 6. So, as far as next session, what are you guys thinking you want to do? A little DM guidance here. Direction. You want to go back to the hut? You got a level.
Maybe we could.
Now that you know what you're looking for? Travel's like, maybe the hut got burned to the ground because of the alchemy fire.
Right? It didn't ever get put out?
Sat there, burned.
Well, the hut wouldn't be able to put it out, but she could. It just takes an action to put it out, but the hut wouldn't be able to do that.
She could command the hut to put itself out.
All right, I'm sure I'm going to need some coding on this aura protection.
There's a guy that does auras.
Right.
Who's that?
And this code they added only set or protection, save, charisma, self.
Friday, are we still good, Sven?
Yes. As long as everybody else is,
I'm still good
either way. But no family.
We finally got out of that freaking cage.
Sort of. You're still within sight.
It's still over there, but we're not in it. We could get thrown back in there any second, but that's fine.
Does anybody have family over or anything?
I just got all my kids here, which is nice. Daughter's home from college.
I'm going
She brought her cat.
Going to my best friend's wife's mom's house. The gun range crew, it's all of us that like to go shoot together. Two turkeys and a ham.
I'm going to smoke two turkey breasts on the Traeger.
Sounds like a rap song or something. Two turkeys and a ham.
Got two turkeys and a ham to eat.
Right. Work. I think the silent spell is the MVP, baby. The silent spell, man.
That was the only reason we got away.
Yeah.
I mean, she can't command nothing. I was like, what?
So, if that silent spell would have been put on the hut and the skull and everything at the beginning, even if she would have got out of the silent spell, she couldn't have commanded the hut to go anywhere or do anything, right? Because it couldn't hear.
Correct. Not until she dispelled it. Yep.
Oh, yeah. Then she dispels it while she's out.
Maybe yeah, she can just move out of it and dispel it, right?
Yeah, do it again while we were over there killing her.
Plus, she couldn't cast any spells when she was in the skull. Right. Everything required verbal. Everything I looked at, I'm like, well, Misty Step, verbal. Dimension door, teleport, verbal. I don't know. I think even teleport's verbal.
Hey, Caesar, I put the aura of protection code in there for you. If you don't want it to be visible on the map, then just remove the yellow.
All right,
All right, where do I add that, though?
Create an effect, add it as an effect.
Just create an effect?
Let's say goodnight to the stream. Let's end the stream. Let's
good night, stream.
If you've been hanging out with us and all that, it's time for you to go to bed.
On your actions tab, add an action.
Right, and then just copy.
An effect to that.
Shit, you can't copy out of chat.
Who are we gonna go raid?
Paste it in Discord if you
anybody
want.
Anybody I'm following?
Yeah.
We're just gonna end it. we're going to bed. We're getting ready for the holidays.
Two effects.
Turkeys are thawing in the fridge. So say goodnight, everybody.
Put that, copy that right into the description. Goodnight, everybody.
Hey, if no one's told you this yet, happy Thanksgiving. Just in case no one said it yet.
Right.
See you guys.
Yeah.